So welcome back to the channel guys, I hope you are all doing absolutely fine. So guys, today in this video I'm going to show you my game which I played just today, in which I delivered checkmate by using the rook. And in this game too I applied the Traxler counter attack. So let's begin. Now in this game too I was playing with the black pieces. My opponent started with e4, e5, knight f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4, bishop to c5. We have the Giacopiano or Italian game on the board. Now d3. Yeah, and now knight to f6. I am allowing the fried liver attack. So that's what we saw in the game. He played knight to g5. I just played d6. This was a very crucial move here. So now my opponent played knight takes f7, forking both my queen and rook. I just moved my queen to e7. He just took my rook by playing knight takes on h8. Now I sacrificed my bishop by playing bishop captures on f2 check. He played king captures on f2. Now I gave him another check, knight to g4 check. That was the idea behind the d6 move, to open up the diagonal for the bishop, and this bishop just gave support to the knight. Now he played king to e2. Now I gave check with another knight, knight to d4 check. He plays king to d2. Now my queen comes into play, queen to g5 check. He plays king to c3. Also my queen's now being attacked, so I retreated my queen to e7. Now he plays knight to f7. Now I played b5. Now he played bishop to d5, attacking my rook. I just moved my rook to b8. Now my opponent played bishop to g5, attacking my queen. But I just played b4 check, and then I moved my queen out of danger by playing queen to d7. Now he plays bishop to e3. I took his bishop and he took back with his king. Now I played queen to e7. Now he plays knight to d2. Now I played c6. He plays bishop to c4. Now I played d5. We have a pawn trade here, and now again he played bishop takes on d5. Now I gave him a check, knight to f5 check. He plays king to f2. Now I played queen to h4 check. He blocks with g3, that attacks my queen. I gave him another check, this time queen to d4 check. He plays king to f3, another check with a capture of the bishop, queen takes d5 check. Now king to e2, now another check with the knight to d4 check. King to f2, another check with a capture of a knight, king, queen to f7 check. He plays king to g2, worst possible move. Now another check, bishop to b7 check. This is my dragon bishop. The best move I think here was to play king to g1, but anyways, king to g1 and give up his rook. But anyways, he played blocked with the knight to f3. I played bishop takes f3 check. Bishop is well supported, and it also forks the king and the queen, and also indirectly attacks the rook. So he took with the queen. Now I took his queen. Now queen takes f3 is a check. He cannot take my queen because of my queen supported by my knight. So he plays king to h3. Now I played g5. Now he plays rook h2 f1, attacking my queen. But first a check, g4 check. King to h4 was the move that he played. I played queen to g2. He captured my pawn by playing king takes d4. I captured his pawn by playing queen takes on h2. Now what? He plays rook to h1, which again attacks my queen. Now again a check. Queen to e2 check. He plays king to h3. Now I played rook to b6, a rook left and threatening a checkmate on my next move. He didn't saw that and attacked my queen. And now I hit the final nail in the coffin with rook to h6, which is an astonishing checkmate. I won't call this an astonishing checkmate because I was way better than him in the endgame. So the speciality about this game was that my king was in the center for the whole game, yet none of his pieces were able to even touch my king, and I checkmated him instead. So back to this position, after my rook to b6, I think the best move for him was to play king to h4 and create some space, king to h4 or pawn to g4 to create some space for the king to breathe. But he didn't saw that and fell into my trap. So in this game I also applied the Traxler counter gambit. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.